Hi, let's finish one thing that I didn't finish in the last video.
We decided to the blue hair what feels more magical and pretty, and the keeping different hair color what creates a good contrast between Earth and the feeder. Then Jean Lutis, like I, like things to be consistent in the universe. We write the new rules about her color and when they shall change, not change, and try to stick with them from that point. I think it will be cool if you guys and some crystal mermaids as alias to the Lolirock girls in the show very soon. Just ask it. Crystal Mermint thinks awesome. But correctly, we already got 5 princes to follow, and they require a lot of attention, especially Ariana. Maybe it's another feeder on spin-off that world mostly be on a feeder? No problem. Iris 15, Talia 16, Ariana 15, Lina 16, Chrisa 15, Mephiston Proxenia Twinks 17, Izura 25, years older than Talia, Missy 15. During the events of Heroes, Talis is supposed to be 7, her Izura is 16, and for the main base, Lev 17, Nathaniel 16, Doc 15, Kyle 17. Most of the teenagers in the show are between 15 to 17 years. Kramer is much older. How much? Well, we don't know. Guys, I will add it for myself. Elvira is 14 years old in my episodes. And in their episode, she is 18. Let's read it. Now that we're talking about magical circles, I need to ask, why doesn't Ari's magic circle don't have a heart symbol? And why does Proxenia not have a butterfly symbol? You probably noticed that most characters have one symbol. Ariana and Walton have moon crescents. Talia, Izira and Heron have diamonds and Sarah. However, we, the royal family of Ophidia and Aries have two symbols, the four branch stars and the heart. We wanted them to have these two symbols, single they are both. The auroras of Ophidia as a realm, and as a royal planet and my kingdom. The heart is the symbol of the realm. What the four branch star is the symbol of the magic. From Proxenia is kind of the thing think. We wanted her to be the anti-Aries. There is a symmetry between Aries and her. So she needed to have two symbols too. One for her magic, which is the lightning, and one for herself, the butterfly. We chose the butterfly because which shape could remind Iris Hempens, and this way we could give Proxenia her overall happen too. I have a lot of magical circles, but it might be thinking too much about it. It is normal that all people have the unimagic circle only to them. As never two people with identical magic circles, or can them be hereditary, so they come natural? Or do the magic users design them? Who knows, they match very well to be two identical magic circles. We wanted them to be different, like a signature. Her a switch rank, some people have pretty similar hand wiring, but others are very different, so everything is possible. As a first, we have one indication for the one effect. Like most anime or Harry Potter, for instance. However, we can't of mess it up at warding and staging, and that up with the same incantation having multiple effects or several different incantations having the same effect. What can it now to fix this mistake? If the spells works by categories, offensive spells like Crystal Offensive, Crystal Corruption, Crystal Retrosum, three range attack health effect can vary. Crystal Pactus, egg and attack, attack, or Atlarina, arrow, ranged attack for the baddies, and Telenok, ground rage attack, and Crystal Barrier attack for the baddies. Defensive spells like Crystal Mom, creating a defensive wall, and Crystal Tactus, shield spell. Detection spells like Crystal Calm, located someone is needed of assistance. Or Crystal Lukuma Sanjari, located somewhere thanks to one item. Invocation spells like Crystal Foros, Tele Summoning a Light Crystal Bell, or a Torajere for the baddies. Healing other spells like Crystal Solventa, Team Offensive spells like Crystal Luxtra, Three Princes, Crystal Quinta, Five Princes, on Tronkeles for the baddies. It really matter as the person who cast the spells want to happen, and the shell shape the spell for that. Words have to shape, but are not absolute, not in our universe. They're more like guide now. If the Luna and Carissa were to be part of the band, what instruments will they play? When even though they are not part of the band, Luna really loves oars, violins, and flutes. And Carissa, on the other hand, really loves saxophones and clarinet. I will add it for myself. If you play a balalaika, I was reading the notes of the series episode, and I'm wondering, what was Isa's hair color when she was a baby? Was this brown like Talia or some other color like black? Okay, to answer this very recurrent question, we decided that Isa's baby Earth's color is a dark brown, is globally the same color as Talia, but little darker, so Rosilla has darker normal hair and larger magical hair compared to Talia. Hope it's help you out. Hello, Team Lolirock. Time for a little, maybe big question. Does episodes have a concrete timeline? I presume the events from each episodes are not from each day of their lives. That will be creepy for twins to stalk princess 24/7. Like, how much time is passed by between episodes? Have the production teams wrote off a timeline, or it was left for audience to think on something? And I'm too deep into more stuff. I need to force to work which. Take care, love your post, bye. Hi, glad you love our universe, so let's try to help you a little. As you probably know, most of the episodes are and should be considered start alone. Many who can watch the show in disorder is not a problem. We suggest you to follow the writing and production order, as expressed in the previous post. But that is not absolute either. If you think one episode first bit is swapped with another, it's up to you. I'd be curious to see some fun episode order. You should consider that a few days up to 1 week or two happen between each episode. It takes usually this much time for the twins to think a new way it annoyed the princess. The exception for me would be between episode 1 to find the princess and any other episode Tara and Tarvayana have to move in. Iris has to learn her few spells, and the princess collects a few gems. So it probably takes about a month for all of that to happen. Again, this is not absolute, just a feeling we had when writing the episodes. Hope this can help you. Now you're free to image whether we want, even if it's in good production with what the stories we tell you. That's also what makes the fandom interesting, at least to me.
So see you soon!